All right, we're here with the demo of the APK downloader plugin, which should be released pretty soon. It's going to be for Android. This is a plugin to help you out with the Android market app size. You know, they let you only have a 50 meg app. So what a lot of people are doing is resorting to asset bundles, which makes for a pretty big mess when you're dealing with a cross-platform game. So this is aimed at making it so that you can use the same exact code base in iOS and Android. And the way it works is, if you've seen Shadowgun or any of the other large games in the Android market, loads up an initial app that then downloads the game in the background. So we got a system here that will hopefully be easy enough for anybody to do. It's a no compile solution like everything else we have. So I'm just going to try and run through a demo here. It's a tricky thing to demo, but we'll see what happens. So what we got here first is this is going to be our actual game. And what you want to do is open up your build settings first. And when you're ready to actually build your game, you're going to put all your scenes in here that are your actual game. So this is going to be the content that gets downloaded later. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go ahead and build this, and we'll call it demo. So this would be with you the process of building your actual game here. And once that runs through and is built, what we're gonna wanna do is run our APK tool on it and close that. So what we'll have here is prepare APK for download in the Prime 31 menu. So what this is going to do is just confirming that you've built your actual game here. And that's important. You're going to want to build the game first here. So we're just going to say yes because we just built the game. And it's going to ask you where your APK file is, and we called it demo APK right in here. So we're going to go ahead and let the APK downloader do its thing. Pay no attention to that. And it's going to ask you where you want to save it. So let's just call it demo, and we're going to dump it on the desktop for the time being. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just upload this to the server here so that it's accessible. Okay, so now we've built our game, we've uploaded it, and we are done with this aspect of things. So now what you can do is we're going to you can actually set up a mini game of sorts if you want. And this scene here, and let's just take a quick look at it. All it has in here is a start download button and a restart app. So the purpose of this is going to be, you can have a mini game here to when you start the download, and gives people something to do while they're waiting for the download to finish. Throw a little 10 meg game or whatnot in here and give them something to do while they're waiting for your actual game to download. And the downloader will actually work in the background as well, so they can actually shut down the app, and it'll post a notification when things are ready. So let's have a look at the actual code here, because this one actually requires a bit of configuration. So this is the relevant code right here. So you need first a URL to an APK. That's going to be your full game, the one that we just output it a moment ago, and I upload it to this location here. There's going to be a couple little options here. So ticker text is going to be the text that appears in the notification tray if the person happened to shut your game down while the download is occurring. So that'll just put a little notification in the tray, and it'll display that text. And there's also two other bits of information here that'll show up. So inside of the actual tray, these two lines will show up. One of them is the title, and the other one is the subtitle. So the subtitle is just smaller text underneath. And what this will let people do is turn off your app and let it download. When it's done, they can just touch the notification and it'll relaunch. So the plugin, in addition to allowing them to put it in the background, if you want to keep it in the foreground the entire time, you can also do that, and then it has a restart app function built into it. So we'll actually send back an event for the download, and if we have a look in here, we can see that we have a download complete event so that you know when the download's done, or if it failed for whatever reason. You can actually cancel it too. We provide a cancel method in there. And there's also a download progress update event. And this event's just gonna, you know, kick off a number between 0 and 100 for the percent downloaded of the app. So you can listen to this event, show a progress bar, you know, entertain people with a little Pac-Man game or some mini game, or just display a progress bar if you want. Totally up to you. So with this all set up, you know, this simple scene is just gonna have those two buttons. So we're gonna go ahead and hop back over here, and we are going to build this. Actually, we're just going to build and run this, because this is going to be the actual APK that you release on the Android market. So this is going to be, oh, no Android device. Let's just fix that and try again. Okay, so I'm just going to open up Logcat here so we can have a look at it. And this is just a Logcat log filtered for Unity messages. And this is pushing right now to the device. And I'm going to include a video of the device as well with this to go side by side so that you can see what's happening on the device during all this. Okay, so we are launching now. You can see we get all the good Unity stuff in here. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to push the start download button now. And right here, this is just logging the download event. So every time the download event kicks off, it pops in there. So I'm going to actually shut down the app now. Okay, so now the app is shut down. And you can see it's still logging the download percent. And this is just for so you can watch when testing. Okay, so the download just completed, and I can see the ticker text appeared in the notification tray. So now I can pull the tray down, and what we're gonna do now is I'm just gonna touch the all done downloading your game in the notification tray, and it's gonna pop open, and bam, now it's opened up to the actual game itself. So that's it in a nutshell. That's gonna be the workflow. You just have to output that game, and we actually strip that APK, the one that's you're gonna put on your web server for download, so that it has no code in it. That way, it's, you know, something you don't have to worry much about people locating it and stealing it, because there's nothing but the Unity data in there. All right, so that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching.